الحمد لله. It's the season. Allergy season. صلى الله عز وجل أن يلطف بنا جميعا. Please don't make salam before the imam. Please don't make salam before the imam. It's very important. Your salah will not going to be valid if you exit for the imam. Understand? I need somebody to translate in Kyrgyzstan language. Where is the Kyrgyzstan? Where is Abu Ali? Abu Ali, say something. Say loud. Abu Ali, it's very important, Habibi.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Şu bratyalar, imam salam bergenge çeyin, salam berbegile deyit da. Antpese namazına kabul oluğu kılat deyit. Не давайте салам, прежде чем имам даст салам, говорит, так как это очень важно, ваш намаз может быть недействительным.
Don't go with the imam, go after the imam. Don't go with the imam, go after the imam.
Не идите вместе с имамом после того, как только он делает салам, тогда давайте салам, говорит.
Give it an example.
На примере.
After me, after I finish.
На примере.
Ассаламу алейкум ва рахматуллах. Ассаламу алейкум ва рахматуллах.
Ассаламу алейкум ва рахматуллах. Ассаламу алейкум ва рахматуллах.
Isn't it simple? But don't go with the imam. Go ahead with me. Ассаламу алейкум ва рахматуллах. Don't do that. Right? I don't mean I meant. Don't clap. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's just the wallahi, nothing else, just a correction. Because it's very important, otherwise the salah, we are jeopardizing our salah. It's very important. Salah, ameen. After the Fatiha, we say, waladhalin. Please don't say ameen. We have brother ameen. He's Abu Ameen. Don't say ameen. It's ameen, not ameen. I heard a couple of nights ago one brother on my right side here saying, Ameen. No, Afwan, 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 I'm sorry. Not in this masjid, another masjid. Waladhalin, Ameen. I'm like, who's Ameen? It is not Ameen, it's Ameen. At the same time, we are not going to do excessively mad on the We don't do that. And it's similar to the adhan. The adhan, when you're given, you don't say, Allah. Where are you going? It's Allah. His majesty name is Allah. Not Allahu Akbar. It's Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So it's very important because it's related to the ahkam, the rule for the tajweed Quran. When imam says waladhallin, see together. لأن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إنه من وافق تأمينه تأمين الملائكة غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. It's a great, great reward. والإمام يؤمن والمأمون يؤمنون والملائكة تؤمن. So we have a three group. The Imam will say آمين. المأمومين, which is you will be saying آمين. And the ملائكة surrounding us in the masjid, you don't see them, they will say with us آمين. If all those three ameens get together, Alim Abdul Rahman, when all those three ameens get together, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, the sin of those individuals, Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive. What a great reward. So we don't want to. And then the Sahaba Ridwanullahi Alayhim, who used to pray behind the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he used to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, they used to say ameen out loud, حتى يرجف المسجد رجفا. until the masjid shook the voice, how it will be very loud and strong. And Ameen, in this position, is not supposed to be quietly with respect. The other madahib who believe the Ameen has to be secretly. Ameen has to be secretly. But the sunnah, the traditional of the Sahaba, they used to say Ameen out loud, the way we do just right now in the masjid. And there is a lot of hasanat related to this. So, حفظكم الله تعالى التزموا سنة نبيكم جزاك الله خيرا أبو علي الله يحفظك أبو علي الله bless you. I don't want to talk about these issues like tonight, but it's very important since we are the nights of the Ramadan and it could fall into the nights of the Laylatul Qadr. Definitely, إخواني في الله أنصح نفسي. I advise myself and to you. Number one, اعبدوا الله عز وجل مخلصين له الدين. Number one, اعبدوا الله عز وجل مخلصين له الدين. Worship Allah عز وجل for the ibadah, pure for him. Sincerity for him, for his cause subhanahu wa ta'ala. No showing off, no tasmi', no murai, no nothing. Because what are we trying to gain? It's something very precious. The night of Laylatul Qadr, 83 years. A good deed's equivalent of it's not more better than the 83 years. It's better. خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفْ شَهْرٍ. Even better than 83 years, ibadah. So ibadah, when we are worshipping, and the ibadah is when you pray is ibadah. When you are giving sadaqah, it's ibadah. And I'm encouraging you, give sadaqah to your masjid. Don't wait Imam Faisal to get up and tell you who's going to give me money, this and that. Give money every night. Few more nights have left. Which one will Allah Azza wa Jalla will accept? We don't know. And we ask Allah, all our sadaqah, Allah to accept. But give it every night, especially when the, your masjid needed your support. Give it. Don't wait your imam to get up and say, give something. Giving sadaqah, it's a great ibadah. Reading Quran is the month of the Quran, Ramadan. Standing up for prayer after you finish even your taraweeh, after you finish your qiyam, especially the brothers who are in i'tikaf, it's the time that you're supposed to do nawafil. Nawafil mutlaqah, what the ulama they call it, means sunan that has no end of it. Two rak'ah, you finish. Two rak'ah, you finish. Two rak'ah, you finish. Two rak'ah, you finish. Until you get tired. And then you rest and you change to another ibadah. It's a great ibadah. It is great ibadah that we should accomplish for these few nights have left. As Allah Azza wa Jalla an yataqabbal jami'an. Ikhwanna, and as I said a couple nights ago, day before yesterday, I believe, all these good deeds that we are earning, please don't give it away easily. Don't give it away to the others. Your sadaqah that you're giving, your fasting, your salah, your all the different ibadah you're doing in it, don't give it away. لا تعطي للآخرين. كيف أعطي للآخرين عبادتي؟ How can I give my ibadah that I perform secretly or publicly? How am I going to give to the others when you backbite them? When you slander them, when you talk about them, when you say something that they don't like it, basically you are giving away your good deeds. So don't do it because it looks like someone who's working all day. At the end of the day, your supervisor will say, no check for you, go home. That's a waste of time. You don't want to do that. So please, أنصح نفسي. Myself is starting first. And to you, my beloved brothers and sisters, حافظوا ألسنتكم. Guard your tongue. And remember the advice of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. من يضمن لي ما بين لحييه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. من يضمن. Who will guarantee for me? Who will give me insurance? Who is the person who will guarantee, will do this for me? The Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying it. To protect and guard what is in you between two jaw. What is in between your two jaw? It's your tongue. And what is between your two legs? Your private part. Means staying away from the haram. And staying away from ghibah wa namimah. And lying and slandering and testifying falsely. Anything that you say from your tongue. So who will protect his guard? Who will guard his tongue and his private part? And I will guarantee that person Jannah. So that means لابد أن نحافظ ألسنتنا ونحافظ فروجنا والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم. So نسأل الله عز وجل أن يحفظكم جميعا وأن يتقبل منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. فنسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. جزاكم الله خيرا. Allah yahfadkum. And when I am giving the nasiha, I am not attacking for no one. It's just a nasiha to Allah wa Rasulihi wa a'immat al-Muslimin wa ammatihim. It's a nasiha, so no one should see it. Is this Imam is attacking us? He meant it for us? No, it has nothing to do. Because we love one another and we should advise one another. As-salamu Allah Azza wa Jalla an yubarik fikum. Day of the week. It is Jumu'ah. It could be the possible the last Jumu'ah of Ramadan. It could be next Friday, Eid. If not, Jumu'ah will be 30 Ramadan. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يحسن خاتمتنا. We did it more than 23 days. Today is 23. And very less have left. I always advise myself and to you, my beloved brothers and sisters, don't get tired. We're almost there. And أكثر الاستغفار. More استغفار. Asking Allah عز وجل more forgiveness. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عنا. And that will be the conclusion of every ibadah that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do. Even Allah ordered him to ask forgiveness when he was about to die. When he was about صلى الله عليه وسلم to departure this dunya, Allah revealed a special surah indicate that his death got close. And Allah Azza wa Jalla ordering his prophet that he should ask forgiveness Allah. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا يا رسول الله فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said اجعلوها في ركوعكم أو في سجودكم. Make this dua in your ركوع and in your سجود. And say it, سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك. Because this is the order. فسبح, glorify Allah. While you are mixing with the حمد of Allah. فسبح بحمد ربك. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك. واستغفره اللهم اغفر لي. That's how he interpretates Allah عليه وسلم. And he made it dua. And he said اجعلوها. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم recite this ayah, Abu Bakr and Siddiq start weeping, crying. The Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, they said, what's wrong with the old man crying? Allah Azza wa Jalla informing him, his Rasul, إذا جاء نصر الله, when the victory of Allah comes to you and the conquer of Makkah والفتح, and you see the people entering the deen of Islam group after group, group after group. If you see this, فسبح بحمد ربك. Abu Bakr started crying. The Sahaba say, what is he crying for? قال أبو هريرة كان أعلمنا أبو بكر. أبو بكر was the most knowledgeable among us. الصديق. Because he realized the meaning of the ayah. The surah is indicating the death of the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, يا أبا بكر. Allah Azza wa Jalla asks to choose which one he wants, his messenger, dunya or akhirah. And I chose the akhirah. So it's time to go. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a couple of weeks, they said, or a couple of months, he passed away. Salawatul wa salam alayhi. So every ibadah that we do, we conclude with the istighfar. Yet we did not finish. We still have 6 or 7 more days to go. But always, the last 10 nights, istighfar, 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 istighfar. And we have to change. We have to change. If you were doing something wrong before Akhi, change. If you were dragging your pants, pull up your pants. If you were eating usury, riba, stop eating the haram. If you were dealing haram, stop dealing haram. Because it is a joke. The person muqim fil ma'siyah and he keeps saying Allahumma ighfir li. The person doing the sin and he's on it and he's saying, oh Allah forgive me. It's a joke. Because the condition of the istighfar is to stop the sinning first and then to regret why I did it. And then ask Allah that you're not going to go back again. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive you. So that's what we need. We need change. And we need to find ourselves, we will be better than Sha'ban. The way we were in Sha'ban, we should be better in Shawwal. So means so better. And I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us those who will benefit the month of Ramadan. Otherwise, wal-iyadu billah, and we're not going to have bad thought about Allah Azza wa Jalla. But we will have a good expectation. He's Rahman al-Rahim. That He will accept our good deeds. When ourselves too, we have to come forward and change ourselves. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will shower us on His mercy. Asalullah an yahfadhkum. You're all tired. You have to prepare for Salat al-Jumu'ah too. So inshallah ta'ala, and come to the masjid early and read Quran. And alhamdulillah, Allah waffaqana an qara'na Surah al-Kahf. It was the rahmah of Allah. It was Jumu'ah. We recite Surah al-Kahf. And we recite Surah al-Sajdah. And we recite Surah al-Insan. And all this was the sunnah of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu an yataqabbal minna wa minkum salih al-a'mal. Jazakum allahu khayr. Sallallahu ala nabina Muhammad.